Welcome back, guys, to another PvE build for the Blackwood chapter. Only 2 days left until the release. This time I've passed with my Magicka Dragonite with a dual Inferno setup. It's always kinda annoying to pass with sensitive skills like Eruption and Scowling Rune, especially with the PTS lag. They are sometimes bugged and you have to basically reset the whole pass if the skill doesn't work like intended. But after 2 hours parsing, I managed to get 100k, which is pretty good for a more support class, since DKs are always playing support sets like Sen or MK in competitive raid groups. I will start with the rotation explanation, which is simple on a Magicka DK, and then followed by the build. Let's go! The rotation is extremely easy. It's a classic dot with spammer rotation, so keep up your dots until the end, and use Molten Whip in between. Use your ultimate Standard of Might not directly at the beginning. Place all of your dots first to empower them all with the 15% damage boost from the banner. I used a Meteor in between just because I couldn't use one more banner in this short amount of fight. In raids or dungeons, I recommend to always use banner, especially in static boss fights. If the boss ports around or has immunity phases, like in Asylum, then it's not really effective to use such a long ultimate like banner. You could use the Destro ultimate or the Meteor then instead. The pre-buff rotation, well, nothing special. You use Channeled Acceleration, swap back to Barb Trap with an add-on like Dressing Room. You use Flames of Oblivion, then Scalding Rune, which takes over 2 seconds until it explodes. Then Eruption into Unstable Wall of Fire, Bar Swap, then Engulfing Flames for the extra 10% more flame damage, into Burning Embers, then Degeneration, and then, in the end, the Standard of Might to empower all of your dots. After, you basically spam Molten Whip until a dot expire. Simple and effective. If you have questions, type it in the comment section below. For PC players, I recommend to use an add-on like Action Duration Reminder, Srenda or Bandits to track all of your abilities. There will be a good skill tracker for console players next patch. I mean, it only took them over 7 years to implement it, but well, they did it. Now, enjoy the pass. After, I will discuss the build with you. Let's take a quick look on the gear. 5 Mother Sorrow on the body. You can use Medusa instead, but then on Jewelry and Front Bar to not lose any penetration and sustain from the light armor passive. So you can slot an extra shield instead of Barb Trap. The new mythic item, Harpooner's Waiting Kilt, which gives 10% more crit damage and almost 6% more crit with 10 stacks. 1 Slime Crawl for extra crit. On the Jewelry, 0 Full Bloodthirsty with 2 0 daggers. 1 Encharged with a flame damage glyph. Why charged? It increases the burning status effect, which gives us more sustain and more damage thanks to decay passive combustion. If you don't have any sustain issues like in optimized raid groups, then you could go with double precise here. Offhand another dagger and precise with the poison glyph. If you don't have any dual Ciroria weapons, just stay on the Inferno Ciroria. DPS wise, it's pretty much the same, maybe 1 to 2k less. On the back bar, of course, the Maelstrom Inferno staff infused with the Berserker glyph. Scales on the front bar are Engulfing Flames for the extra 10% more flame damage. Burning Embers, a strong dot. Molten Whip, our spammable. Degeneration for Major Sorcery, so we can use the Heroism Potions. This one's here, which gives minor heroism to gain more ulti points. Inner Light for extra Magicka and Major Prophecy. And Meteor for also extra Magicka and more burst damage than the banner. On the back bar, Eruption, Unstable Wall of Fire, Barb Trap with Medusa as set, slot a shield here instead. Scalding Rune, Flames of Oblivion, and Standard of Might. Make sure that you have Inner Light on the front bar and Flames of Oblivion on the back bar to gain Major Prophecy on both bars, so we can use the Heroism Potions without losing any crit. Khajiit is the best choice, like on every PvE Magicka class at the moment, followed by High Elf and Dunmar. Asmundus, the Thief, for extra crit. As Bafut, the Ghastly Eyeball. In raids, if you need more HP and if you can sustain it, use the Arteon Picklefish Bowl, or for more damage without any HP bonus, the Green Max Magicka Food, which gives more Magicka. Quick look at the CPs, the blue ones are Backstabber, Fighting Finesse, Deadly Aim, and the new one, Master at Arms. If you can't flank the enemy, use Thaumaturge instead. Master at Arms, by the way, is definitely stronger than Thaumaturge. You just have to take a look on the Molten Whip and the Light Attack damage. It's higher than all of our dot damage, which is kinda sad for dot class. Red CPs, Rejuvenation, Boundless Vitality, Slippery, and Ironclad. That's the end of the video, I hope everything is clear. If not, type your questions down below. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and like the video. The next PvE build will be probably a Magicka Warden one. I will upload it in 1 or 2 days. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, stay healthy, and I see you in the next video. Ciao ciao.